Hello everyone, my name is Carol and I'm working as a partnership manager at TikTok. Today, I want to tell you a bit more about gaming on a TikTok. I have some information about the platform for you, also some more detailed information about the gaming industry on TikTok, and some information about best practices for creatives in gaming industry. So let me start with showing you my opening screen. I hope you can see it now. And I'm super excited to be here and to be able to present a DevPlay TikTok as a platform for gaming industry. So let's start with TikTok's mission. TikTok's mission is to inspire creativity and bring joy. You can easily see it by watching TikTok that a lot of stuff that is there is actually new. The trends are being created on TikTok. Also, a lot of content that is on TikTok is very joyful. It's supposed to make you happy. But TikTok is also a unique platform. It's unique because it's mobile first, full screen, sound on vertical video platform. Our community is authentic, open, creative, and inclusive. And also something which is totally unique on a platform like this is For You page. For You page is our feed. It allows you to watch videos that are actually selected for you based on your previous interaction and watching of other content. And it allows you to discover a lot of new things like new effects, new music, new creators. Our interface is created to discover new content. On For You feed, you have personalized, customized, and diverse content. The content is delivered to you based on your interactions and watch time of various content. If you watch a lot of gaming videos, you probably will receive a lot of them too. If you watch a lot of very specific game videos, you will receive a lot of these specific game videos, but probably as well, you will receive a lot of different stuff based on your location and demographic. Another part of the interface of TikTok is Explore page. You can find there most trending hashtags, sounds, and effects, and see what's going on the platform. The last part of the interface that is created to discover is the Profile page. There you can find all the videos of your favorite creator or the creator your profile entered and see how many views they get and in general see what they present. And For Your page is the most creative place on the internet. You can discover a lot of interesting stuff, a lot of interesting things, and this is place where more than 100 million users from US spend over an hour on daily basis. This is a lot of time and a lot of users because this content that they can find on For You feed is super, super interesting for them. They wanted more and they want to see what's next, what's on the next TikTok. We have also data on the engagement of our content. As you can see on this chart, and TikTok seconds spent in app per session are almost as big as YouTube. But bear in mind that TikTok's content, the longest video is currently up to 3 minutes. Usually it's much shorter. However, the longest video format is up to 3 minutes. It's not a surprise that YouTube has the most time spent in app per session. However, the content there is usually much, much longer. So let's move on to the gaming part. So gaming on TikTok plays a vital part on the platform. There's a lot of people looking for gaming content and there's a lot of gaming content on the platform itself. People post how they game, how they play. And here I have a sneak peek for you about the gaming on TikTok.
Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. All the way up. All the way up. you need. I'm all the way up. 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 Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up.
TikTok is a unique place for gaming and the culture to collide and merge. People use TikTok to discover new things like memes, moments, new videos, new trends. And those trends and those things actually are shaping gaming culture today. Our trends from TikTok are moving to the real life and boosting not only games, but also other games or oriented or games connected things. On TikTok, you can find very traditional approach to games, which is product focused, like unboxings of new consoles, gameplay from your favorite games, or some Easter eggs or tips and tricks how to do some crazy things on the games you know. However, there is also a very fresh and unique way that our creators show on the platform. First, you can find a lot of crazy recreations when they incorporate gaming into real life. Another thing is gaming culture, showing how the life of the gamer looks like. And the last part is sound. Because sounds play a vital role in TikTok. You can find also sounds from the game on TikTok and as a part of a content people look for and listen to. TikTok allows gamers to discover new gaming products. It's not only all the time about the games, but also about the gaming setup or gaming accessories. 45% of users discovered a gaming product or service on TikTok, and 37% bought or considered buying a new gaming product or service after seeing it on TikTok. Because on the platform, you can show to our users anything, and if it interests them, they are happy to interact and happy to follow. So make sure your content is interesting and allows our users discover something new. We can see it as well for the holidays like Christmas or Black Friday. Of TikTokers who reported buying something last Christmas were TikTok player, 42% of them bought something connected to the gaming. For Black Friday, it was even higher because it was 45% of users that bought something last Black Friday, it was connected to gaming. So as you can see, gaming is a big thing on TikTok and big thing, and TikTok influenced gaming as well highly. However, let's move on to something which is very important for us, which is the land of creativity in TikTok. There are many things that you can do to engage your audience, and there are plenty of creators that are working in a gaming industry and making really, really great content. Here, we have some content snapshot from TikTok. As you can see, there are different hashtags, different things shown. There's gaming fails, gaming setups, gaming in real life, best cosplays, and mobile gaming. These are just the examples. The number of the hashtags connected to gaming are infinite. And also, you are able to create one as well. However, for our audience, gaming is not the only thing that they watch on TikTok. Here, we have a sneak peek of what our gaming users, gaming people interested in gaming on TikTok, look for apart from gaming. As you can see, it's daily life, comedy, food and drink, drama, animals, family relationship, talent, fashion, and sports. So it's not always about the gaming. It's also about different scenes from our daily life, something funny and something connected, for example, to food. So if you want to do a quality content for a gaming audience, you have to also bear in mind that those parts of their life are also important for them, like daily life or comedy. So maybe let's start doing something funny. But it's very important to make a content that doesn't look like an ad. On TikTok, it's super important to have a proper content that is native to the platform. Our platform and the way ads are shown also brings this organic feeling to ads. 43% of users feels that advertising on TikTok blends in with organic content. It's very important to have it in mind as well when you are creating your promotion content, your ads. Blend in to the organic. Make your ad look like TikTok. Another important part is to remember that there are different parts of the TikTok environment. You can have your organic profile with your organic content, and organic content is graded in a different way. It's based on interest, how your content arouses interest around our audience. There's also paid promotion, where you can improve or increase the number of video views or reach of your TikToks, of your videos through paid promotion. It helps a lot, especially, for example, during a game launch or some promotion you are having, I don't know, from the mobile app or maybe some other reason. And the last part is creator partnerships. Creators play a vital role, and they are important part of the TikTok environment. So having access to them and using creators to actually promote your product, promote your game, is also a very important thing. To have a fully utilize all the possibilities to promote your game or product on TikTok, you have to use all three parts. However, you can also have them separate and use them in a different way. For example, having organic as the most important part with some additional paid picks and some very rarely creator partnerships. However, one question which I receive a lot of time is, what is good game creative? And moving on to this part, I want to show you some examples and some ideas how to make a great creative for your game. And I want to start with a very simple thing: where your content will be shown. So basically, the most important part in here is the safe zone. Safe zone is a place where there are no buttons, nothing actually interferes with your content. Other part is the captions and description of your ad and your profile. And the last part in paid promotion is CTA button. You can have different messaging here, and you should use the one that actually suits you the most. So please remember, creating the content that your content is shown full screen. However, the most important messaging has to be in the safe zone. And let's move on to the golden rule. First of all, keep your videos short and sweet. Up to 15 seconds is enough to arouse the interest and convince your customer to take your game, download it, and start playing. Second, remember with the full screen. On TikTok, you have the whole space of the screen to be used to promote your messaging. However, remember about the safe zone, which I mentioned in the previous slide. Also, your content has to be immersive, because it's super easy to swipe to the next part, to the next TikTok. So start very strong. Make your audience want to stay and see the end of the ad you are just showing to them. And the next thing is sound on. Sound play important part of TikTok. So use the sound. This sound can be either from our library, or you can use your own sounds, like, I don't know, someone talking, or maybe the music you want to have in the app. And remember, about hitting the video key beats, picking the right music, and including caption and call to action. Let me develop a couple of those rules. First of all, make it simple and don't put a lot of information into one TikTok video. Simplicity is the important part of TikTok. You don't have to create a very difficult, a very complicated content. It has to be simple so people can immerse straight away and see the whole ad at once. First of all, very important part is use the vertical format. If you can do it, especially if you can cut your content to vertical format, or do you have vertical format, please use it. Full screen videos are much better performing ones on TikTok. Also, remember about keeping it short and sweet. Up to 50 seconds is totally enough because people and our audience can swipe at any moment. So keeping it short is very, very good thing to do. Another thing, your content has to be convincing. We have a paid promotion of hashtag challenge when you can create your own hashtag and challenge our users to create a content with this hashtag based on the instruction you are giving them to do. It's super engaging format and it's very unique to TikTok. This is the only platform with such advertising opportunity. It usually has high engagement rates and users really create a lot of content that actually fits the instruction. So it allows you to engage people and challenge them to do something for you. Another important part is keeping native tools. TikTok has a very specific way of communicating, like descriptions, like having a person quite often to talk to people. This is also very organic thing. And in ads, it's super important to include those things into your paid promotion. So take a look, look TikTok for some time, use it and see how other creators, especially in your industry, communicate with users. Look for TikTok that have a lot of views and see what's there that makes them so popular. Because usually it's about content, but also there may be some parts that make TikTok popular, like, for example, descriptions or maybe voiceovers. Another thing, be original. Think new and think original about your content. You can take part in viral trends. If you go to explore page, you will see a lot of hashtags that are trending currently, and maybe there are some that you can use to actually create content and make it go crazy popular on the platform. So look for trends, look for the ones that suits you best and create content to take part in those trends. Another thing is be unique. Think of your unique selling proposition for users. Is your content unique to the platform? Is your content unique to industry? What value your content brings to the user? Is it funny? Is it educational? Is it inspirational? This is the values that our users are looking for. They are looking to discover new things. So think about it, we're creating content. What thing you're allowing them to discover with this video? Another important thing is to be relatable. Use the power of influencer as a creator to make your content trustworthy. Influencers are the creators that have a huge numbers of followers and they can influence their audience decisions pretty easily. So they can recommend them your game. They may play your game and show the game to their crazy number of followers. This is up to you. How do you want to approach it? However, influencers playing a very important role to showing the trustworthiness of your game. And also, another option is to show the player perspective, show how the game look like, show the parts of the game into the ad, show what player can expect from your game while playing it. So you can include actual gaming experience or maybe some CG animation showing the most important part of your game to the users. And next, be noticeable. Show your logo as a big part, show the name of your game. So person can easily connect your ad with a very specific game, with a very specific product. And you have to do it in a very strong visual impression to increase the brand recall or product recall. Also, if you have some iconic intellectual IP, is it very important for game investors to show it? If you have, I don't know, a character or maybe a part of a game or, I don't know, sword in a game, it's very important to show it. And if you don't have one, create on TikTok, find something that's very iconic to your game, to your product, and show it on TikTok and use it, for example, on every TikTok you have like very crazy character that people love. Use it on TikTok and bring the love of the character to more people. So it's very important to use the logo and iconic characters or iconic things from your games on TikTok. And last but not least is being genuine. Set the right expectation about the game so people will know what to expect by downloading it. And also have the upbeat music to make them happy and joy, and they will feel joy while playing it, while thinking about downloading it. Also, the storyline can be winning or losing, but remember the storyline should make audience being hooked to the content, to the video you are showing to them. And about the music, remember about three aspects that are super important. First of all is tempo. We see that music with a high tempo and upbeat sound tends to have higher view through rates. Also, using famous music is a good part to actually promote your video, your content, because music on TikTok is a vital part and people are listening to the most famous artists. Or have an original music, like I said, some commentary, someone talking, to actually create your own music to the video. But please remember that for some of the music, you will need additional authorization to allow the song to be in your app. And please let me show you a couple of examples and I will comment them as well to see why those ads are quite good. First off, we have a Shakes and Fidget game. I will show you two ads from their paid promotion and I will tell you why those ads are quite well done. As you could see in the ad, they were using the safe zone very well. Most of the content appeared there. Also, they were showing the part of the game, the characters that you can choose to play the game. So basically the user could easily see what class they can play from the very beginning before even entering the game. So this type of content is quite good because it allows users and audience to actually get to know the game before even starting it. And let's move on to another content, to another video. Same here. Why is using of the space, and also something important, connecting a person with a CGI elements of the game, like swords, shield, armor. It's also quite interesting because it allows users to see something interesting, something new, and also engage them in a way. So this kind of a game, this kind of content is very interesting for the users, and they, those two ads performed really, really nicely. Another example is from Board King. Here also, I have two videos to show you about this game. Let me start with the first one.
Yes!
Also, very simple ad. However, you can, as you could see, there was some emotions, there was a joyful music, and there was also a gameplay. So you could see how the game looks like. It's very easy to do and very simple to actually follow and see what's there for you. So let's move on to another video. Here you could find two storylines. One was winning and one was losing. And you could see the parts of the game as in a gameplay, in the gameplay windows below the player window, and two emotions that were very strong, like super excitement, happiness from the girl, and the failure and the losing feeling from the guy. And also it's very simple. However, it shows how the game looks like, and it also brings an audience to the game because they want to check if it's really that exciting as shown in here. So that's all from my side. I hope you like my content, and feel free to ask me any question on the Q&A session. Thank you so much.
Hello again, we are live with Carol.
Carol, hello, hello.
Hello, it's nice to meet you, and sorry, you know, we can't meet in person, but thanks for taking the time to speak and support our event. So a couple of questions for you. I think your lecture was very interesting. TikTok is a social media network that is less known to game developers, I believe, but certainly one with a significant potential that has been growing quite a lot recently. So I think what you presented was very useful for developers who are trying to promote their game on TikTok. So thank you for that. So you talked a lot about best practices and what to do. So one question would be, are there things that do not do this? I mean, what are some don'ts in terms of promoting a game on TikTok?
Yeah, basically there are some don'ts. Usually the don't is don't use the same content for a very, very long time, because users on the platform, they expect something new every time they scroll. So basically TikTok is built in a way that every time you scroll, something new is shown to you. And if you're using the same content for the same ad for a very long time, users from the very first second, they know that it's the ad they've seen some time ago. So basically they scroll it super fast. Our lifespan of a content is actually 1 to 2 weeks, depends on a content. So basically you should be rotating content and changing it every 2 weeks in paid promotion, because organic content is shown to you once, but paid promotion you are expecting it to be shown more than once to the user. So you have to really keep it fresh and change it frequently. The other don't I would that I could say is actually having the like keeping the ad that in paid promotion, keeping the ads that are not performing well. It's also a thing to actually test on the platform, have a couple of creatives, not only one, but a couple of them, and test which performs better and which performs worse. And I see some of the advertisers, they are keeping all their creatives because they I don't know have free, and even though one of them is performing really badly, they still keep it. It's better to actually focus on the ones that are performing well and try to recreate them like in a similar way, and then to keep them keep the ones that are performing badly. And actually, I think mostly that's it. Those are like the biggest mistakes usually advertisers are doing on the platform.
Cool, thanks. We have a couple more coming in from our viewers. So question from Diana, thanks for the presentation. Hashtag for you is a very popular hashtag in TikTok. Is there any correlation between this hashtag and the chances of a post showing up in someone's feed? Basically, will the for you hashtag generate more views?
Not really, because in for you feed, the things that are shown are based on your profile. So basically, if you are interested in gaming, what you will see are probably the content that we are having as a gaming content, right? So that's why it's shown to you on a for you page. Basically, the hashtags are playing a vital role, but in a different way. On TikTok, you are using hashtags to allow users to find your content through this hashtag. So basically, if you are having, for example, gaming hashtag gaming, if someone is interested in gaming and looking for a new game to play, they will look probably through hashtag gaming. And with hashtag gaming, they will see all the TikToks with this hashtag shown in a aggregated page with this hashtag. So for me, hashtags are more like a possibility to be found by the user if you are using them properly, if we are marking the content right way. If our we have a game, for example, for Halloween, we should add hashtag Halloween, because if someone is interested in looking for Halloween inspiration, maybe a game you are actually promoting will be part of it, right? If you're having like a racing or car game, also marking it like a car game, car talk, or automotive, probably because those users that might be interested in this game are looking through this hashtag, or they are checking those hashtags. Because when you enter a hashtag page, you will see all the TikToks with a mark, like with this hashtag sorted by the popularity, right? So for you page is a big thing, but it's not giving you the 100% chance that you will appear. If the content is good and if it's really a thing people want to see, it will appear. Probably if you are looking on your For You page, you will see a lot of content is having this hashtag, but also plenty of TikToks are not having hashtags at all. If the content is interesting, it will be shown to you. If it's not really interesting, it probably will is a high chance you won't see it at all.
Okay, and the final question, do you think that it is worth sharing gameplay highlights adjusted to the vertical format, or is it better to focus on more real life footage that is connected to the game somehow?
Actually, I think both ideas are good, because gameplay allows you to actually show to the users what they will experience during gameplay, right? Showing it in a different way, like in the real life, users have to have the context of the game, right? So for example, in Grand Theft Auto, it's super easy because like a lot of people were playing it, and the scenes and some actions are very specific to the game, so it's super easy for recreation. However, if the context is well known among users, you can use it. But in general, I think gameplay is also playing a vital role, and at the beginning, I think it's better to use it to use a gameplay than the recreation and things like this. So for me, gameplay at the beginning is much better approach.
Thank you. We are very short on time, so we'll have to end the Q&A session here. I think there are a couple more questions. I highly encourage viewers to reach out to Carol on our Discord. And Carol, if you can answer maybe a couple more questions there, that would be awesome. Thanks
sure.
a lot. We're going to move to the next session. Thank you, Carol.
Thank you so much.